just the way it is. Some things will never change. That's just the way it is.
What was your most memorable moment at Jericho High School?
My most memorable moment. What was yours?
My most memorable moment at Jericho High School was being in Miss Rankin's class in 10th grade.
Most memorable moment, it had to be when Peter Lizio tried to drive his truck up that hill.
No moment in Jericho High School is...
Well, we can't say. The year's not over yet.
I know.
My exciting moment was when I got kicked off of JS by Stacy.
My most memorable moment at Jericho, you see here, was the vandalism of Gene Hirsch's car, of ripping out the stereo, kicking in the windows and the side doors.
You know I'm a dreamer, but my heart's a gold. I had a runaway high, so I wouldn't come home low. Just when things went right, it doesn't mean they're
we'll be right back. We asked Gary Tannenbaum what his most memorable moment was in Jericho High School. Gary?
My most memorable moment was definitely getting my car and going home at the end of the day. That's my most memorable moment.
Dale at the air to Mr. Weiss tires and I got in big trouble for it. That's my most memorable moment.
My most memorable moment in school is the day I met Dale Smith.
I'm kidding. You're not taping. You're taping?
Are you taping? Are we going to be on JSTV? I really...
This is enough for the senior book. Can I tell you my most exciting moment?
No, we don't want to know.
My memorable moment had to be when we're all down by the gym and we had our dirt bikes there and I decided to take RJ Alessi's 250 XL for a spin around the football field out by the track. And I started off really well, to tell you the truth, in first and second gear. And third gear was a little rough. I got it up to around 45, then I got up to around 50 and about fifth. As I changed into sixth gear at around 65, I sort of lost control of the machine, so you could say. And I did a couple flips, twists, tumbles, crash, bang, boom, and I wound up lying on my back about 100 yards away from the bike.
Kneel down, you sinners, cross three lines, we live.
The most memorable moment is when I missed the laugh against Mineola and everyone started laughing at me. Very embarrassing.
My most memorable moment of high school has got to be when Brett Vitensky and Scott Barra put a ski pole through my eye on the Canada trip and made me spend 5 days in a French hospital. Thank you, Brett and Scott.
The moment is this year, homecoming, when me, Wendy, Stephanie, Dana, Carrie, and Linda did the road rally in Wendy's car. We had the best time. I love you all.
All right. My most memorable moment was February vacation when we went to Canada, and we were just kicked out of Fridays because there was this whole big fight and shit. Delza's driving his car, and in the car is Delza, Jeff Gluck, Jason Blank, Jason Halpern, me, Mike Grillo, and Jen Silver. And we all are so drunk it's ridiculous, and we just want to get back to the hotel.
Oh, when I said okay. To go over the cliff?
So what happens is we're all saying, go over the cliffs, make a right. And everyone's screaming, make a right, make a right. And out of nowhere, Jen Silver goes, make a left.
And
Delza makes a left. And we're lost for like an hour and a half.
most memorable moment is when Carrie Paber in fifth grade was at my house, fourth grade, was at my house. We were playing tag with my dog, Alfie, and he took a nice chunk of her on her ass, and that was my most memorable
moment in Jericho High School. It was fortunate enough to happen with my friend over here, Gene Hirsch. We were in Miss Antonucci's class, English term paper, which we had to pass. Me and Gene just happened to be fighting one day, and as Gene strolls, maybe I should say runs at me to grab me, he just happened to slip on that piece of loose leaf paper and fall flat on his face. That was my most memorable moment in Jericho High School.
My most memorable moment in Jericho High School, it was 10th grade, homecoming. Delza, the terror, was coming after me, right? But I was so brave, and I took judo and all this karate, you know, all that Eastern European shit, you know? And I fought him off. And now, me and Dallas are friends. Very happy to say that. He's filming me right now. So, Dallas, it's been great. Stick your hand out, a little handshake. Thanks.
Jericho. My most unmemorable moment definitely belongs to the man sitting right there. Jason Blank. He is responsible for my most unmemorable moment. Turn the camera back, please. Thank you. Last year, 11th grade, it was me, Jay, the infamous Aaron Edelman, and the more infamous Daniel Goldfarb were hanging out. So Jay's like, all right, it's 6 o'clock, we got to drop him off at Amy's. So on the way to Amy's, I go, Jay, don't call my mother. Don't say you hung out with me. Don't even call her. He's like, okay, Jeff. Then I go, Jay, don't call my mother. I said it at least 15 times. And everyone yelled at me. He's like, shut up. So I'm like, fine, he's not gonna call my mother. So I hang out with Aaron and Fob. We went to some party, got broken up at 1, hung out till 3. I got so blitzed, and I had to go to California the next day, so I had to go home and pack. So I come home, and the light's on in the kitchen, and Peggy Plath is waiting. I come in, and she goes, well, who are you hanging out with? I'm like, she's like, Jason called. He said you were hanging out with him, and he wanted to go out with you again because he was bored, and he's worried. Yep, that's why you did it. And he was worried because he didn't know where you were, and Aaron was driving, and Danny was with you. And I go like, and my mouth hit the floor, and I'm drunk. I drooled as my mouth hit the floor because I was drunk, and I just thought, that stupid fucking idiot.
My most memorable moment of Jericho High School, actually junior high school, was going out with Jason Halpern in 7th grade.
It was 8th and 9th.
7th grade. And
it was not 7th grade. It was.
That was just the highlight of my entire life, and he told me every word to say, so don't believe any of it.
I did not.
Expecting the worst, are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we never say never. Sitting in a sandpit, life is a short trip. The music's for the sad man. Can you imagine when this race is won? Turn our golden faces into the sun. Praising our leaders, we're getting in tune. Music's played by the madman. Forever young, I want to be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever, forever. Forever young, I want to be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Play. So many dreams swinging out of the blue. Let them come
My most memorable moment in Jericho is when Carrie Podver crashed into my car in the parking lot. Come on, Kat. Come on over here. Carrie Podver. Okay. My most memorable moment in high school was with Carrie Podver in driver's ed at Holy Child with Mr. Cohen as a teacher when she was doing a K-turn and instead of pressing on the brake, she pressed on the gas and went flying on someone's car, onto the lawn actually. And Mr. Cohen goes, "Get off the lawn now!"
Driving down Wheatley Road, who do I see on the side of the road? Danny Goldfarb. Pick him up. Drive about 10 feet. Back of my car slips out. BMW in a tree. Everybody knows the story.
My most memorable moment is following Delza and Grillo home. We were on the way back from Canada, and we were stopped at the thing before the border. All of a sudden, Delza gets pulled over for something, and how Jason Pollock and I are really nice, we waited for them. All of a sudden, I don't know how much I can say about this. All I know is that we got stopped at the border. Never thought it would ever happen in my whole life. We stayed there for at least 3 hours. Of course, we were nice enough to wait for them because we didn't want Dallas and Bill to walk home. So the end story is we got stopped. I'll leave out a few details that you don't have to know, but we waited for them. We drove home with like 7 people in the car, got home like it pretty late. Peskin pissed us all off, got us lost. And the end thing is it ended a really sick trip to Canada.
My most memorable moment is when I'm trying to watch the shuttle go off, okay? And my darling friends call me over to say hi, and they trip me and they make me fall on my ass and I cry for 2 hours. That's my most memorable moment.
There's been a lot of talk about this next song. Maybe too much talk. This song is not a rebel song. This song is Someday, Bloody Someday. I can't believe the news today.
cry. We eat and drink while tomorrow they die. The real battle yet begun. The great, the big G, Jesus won.
Specific memorable moment. I had a great time in high school. I'm sorry it's over. I'm sorry that I'm leaving all my friends. And
I love you,
Dels. I love you, Dels. That's it.
Memorable moment is when Aaron, this alumni animal right here,
and his brother,
slipped, falling. His hand went through the metal thing. This was not here at this time. And his hand went through there, and he did not realize that he was had a big puncture wound through his hand until he tried to get up, noticing that he was stapled to the ground. That's my most memorable moment.
A moment was when my dad came home early from his trip, right in the middle of my open house, and turned the sprinklers on because he was really pissed, and like everyone ran away. It was great. Thanks, Dad.
Here we are with a distinguished graduate, Aaron Edelman. What do you think about the school now?
It sucks.
Any other comments?
Nope.
Mr. Theobald, do you want to join in on this conversation?
No.
That's it, Del.
You gonna speak? Okay. See, my friend Brian here, he's a little mute. So, he told me in his own special way that his most memorable moment is the night that the beverage barn burnt. He ran in. What day was it? He still has his last beer unopened, waiting on his dresser from Beer Barn.
Thank you.
We're here with the Jericho High School Student Commons, and we're discussing our most memorable moments.
Again.
Karen Lazarus.
I don't have one. I'm not going to do a memorable moment, but I'll tell everyone that I'm going to miss them, and I'll miss seeing you every day, and I love you all, and good luck in your life, and Dells, you're awesome. Feel better. You're the best fighter I know. Dells the Smith. Hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on, ears out.
Good luck to everyone in the future. I love you all very much.
You're original.
I love
you're
you original. All. And see you later. Take care.
That was the rudest thing I've ever heard, not to mention my name and her most memorable moment. Because I was definitely her most memorable moment in Jericho High School.
Don't give yourself so much credit.
That's all I have to say. No, my most memorable moment was getting in the Jericho football game for the first time ever. And my first three plays were fumble, fumble, interception, out of the game.
Why are you coming back down to me?
You didn't go.
I don't have one.
She loves you also. Bye.
All right, we're here today, June 7th. Eighth, to discuss the 1988-89 yearbook, and just want to point out one thing. There's Jody Shaliff, and Jody Shaliff again,
and again,
and Jody, oh my God. And Jody, there she is again.
By the way, Jay and I counted.
Oh, well, there she is. We
counted 32 pictures.
32.
Just to mention, who's in charge of the yearbook? Jody Shaliff?
Who put the pictures in?
Jody Shaliff?
Who's on every page?
Jody Shaliff?
And, you know, we don't want to be, what? Oh, the big picture? All right, we got the big picture coming up over here. There it is. Centerpiece. Jody Shaliff? Next page.
Turn, and,
What
a surprise. There she is again.
And look at that. Jody Shaliff. Jody Shaliff with Joel. All right. Thanks.
All right. Most memorable moment. Let's go. Was it Lizette's party, ninth grade? Me, Carrie. Who else is in my car? Ronnie. Danielle was in my car because no one drove. My brother was taking everyone home. Carrie was so drunk off her butt. I can't even begin to explain to you that. Time to go home. Time to go home, okay? And all of a sudden, everyone, about 10 people, pile into my brother's car, which is now my car. And all of a sudden, someone goes, oh my God, she's throwing up! Oh my God, she's throwing up! Carrie threw up all over my brother's car. You had to be there. It was the funniest thing in the world. And that's it.
The moment is when I left my dyke school and came to Jericho and met cool
people.
Our Lady
of Mercy.
Our Lady of Mercy, which is a major fag school. Coming here with this jerk, but that's my most memorable moment.
Don't have a most memorable moment. Oh, the day I met Danielle. The day I met Danielle was the most memorable moment in Jericho.
Oh, Jared.
But anyway, I'm all sweaty. I just wanted to get on the camera.
My most memorable moment with my man Pollock was me and Jay went to the bathroom. Pollock took a shit on top of a piece of cardboard. Brought this shit down with me, walked this shit down, put it in Josh Lehman's locker. Then we kind of wimped out and we took it out of the locker. Running down the hall, dropped the shit in the Palo Alto's, pan over there. That is where the shit was in the hall. Panning over here, we're panning over, the shit was over there in the hall. And there's the man who took the shit right there. Get him on camera. That is the man who took the shit. I was the one who held the shit, he took the shit.
Ever-changing world pushes me through another door.
wish that I could give you something more, that I could be yours. How do we explain something that took us by surprise?
The most memorable moment that I can think of right now is driving down Achilles some French Boulevard in Quebec at about 70 miles an hour. Mike starts playing with the wheel and we got about three joints going at once. And we just sort of swerve around and slide around the road. And we're thinking, are we going to die? But it didn't matter because we were all in Canada and we were partying for a week straight. And that's the most memorable moment I can think of, right?
Most memorable moment's probably pocketing $800 after the road rally. Yeah, $200 to the winner, but $800 to my pocket. Thank you.